Hi everyone, here's a quick recap of our Jazz It Up class today. So we started with a little bit of improv practice. We asked you to come up with three steps. We practiced on the Suzy Q and on the Shine Shoes and on the Kickball Change. We took each step individually and then together, and we played with different ideas. So big and small, level changes, up and down, changing the shape of the move, taking them around, changing the arms and the flavor of them, and also combining them, taking a piece of them and combining it with another piece. So for example, we had our kick ball change that could go into a kick ball change and the Suzy. Or we had our shine shoes that could go into a Suzy. Or giving our Suzy Q a shine shoes flavor. Next we did a sequence, a routine, which was to slightly slower music tonight so we could really explore the groovy movements. We started with Shorty George going up and down. We went 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, going back with some ball change, 8 and 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7. And the starting for that was to clasp the hand in front and boogie back. And we repeated 8, then 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Going back, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7. Then had a boogie drop, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a quick with a rock into a turn. So we went boogie drop, rock, turn, down. From here, some fishtails, a slow, a quick slow. We repeat on the other foot. A boogie drop, rock, turn, down, fish, tail, a quick slow. We went forward again with our boogie forwards, boogie forward, and a double sweep. Finishing by changing weight onto the right foot. From here, we're into two. Josephine Baker style move, or a reverse bicycle movement. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A slow, a quick slow. Then we went around with a step, close step, a step, close step, rolling the hips. So the Josephine Baker, the hips are going out to the side, and in the turning one, they're going forward and back. Quick, slow, down on 8, and then our John Bobbles move, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's a kick forward, and a chuck forward, and back, and forward, and back, and the switch, we bring the right foot forward, stepping all our weight on the right foot, and at the same time we take a chuck back on the left, and we go. All right, let's walk through the whole routine from the top. I'll do it once the same way as you and once facing you with no music first. A 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A 2, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7. A 3, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. A 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A boogie drop, quick, down fish, tail, a quick slow. A boogie drop, quick turn, down fish, tail, a quick slow. Boogie four, and a double sweep. A Josephine Baker, a 5, 6, 7. A 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7. Going right, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7. And hop, 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 hop. And I'm facing you. A 5, 6, 7. 8 and 1, 2, 3. A 5, 6, 7. 8 and 1, 2, 3. A 5, 6, 7. Shorty George, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. A 1, 2, 3. A 5, 6, 7. A boogie drop. Ha ha. Down fish. Tail. A quick slow. A boogie drop. And turn. Fish. Tail. A quick slow, going 4, 2, 3, a double sweep. a gentle, say, thin, a quick, quick, slow. A 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, and a round. 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7.
This is when my sugar walks down the street.
Oh.
Let's warm up.
Let's walk down the street.
Pump those arms up to the sky.
Shimmy around.
Shimmy around. We're just doing a little warm up. Come and join us when you're ready. So we're just warming up, come and join us when you're ready. Move those shoulders.
Shoulder and the hip. Those shoulders forward and back. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow.
And get the full range of movement, nice big movements.
And hips around. Side to side. And pulse around.
Mess around.
Really
pulse. Try to feel the beat of the music as you go round.
Big arm movements. And swimming back. Down, up. up.
Push the thigh back.
Pop.
Cool, okay. Now, welcome to everyone. If you want to adjust your cameras so we can see more of you, that helps us to see what's happening. So,
as long as you can see us as well.
Yeah, as long as you can see us as well, but that would be great. Okay, fantastic. Now, I thought today, for a part of our warm-up, we're going to choose three steps. And what we'd like is one of you to give us a step. So can anyone, you might have to unmute yourself, call out a step you know or that you like. Susie Q. Okay, good choice, good first choice. Anna, can you show us a Susie Q?
Okay, Susie, Susie, Susie Q. Susie, Susie, Susie.
Okay, let's all do some Susie Qs. Ready? Five, six, a Susie Q. Susie. A Susie, a Susie Q, a Susie, a Susie, a Susie Q. Are we all happy with the Susie Q?
Yes.
So how can we explore that move? How can we do it differently? Give me one thing that we could do differently. One thing that would change that classic Susie Q.
Making it bigger or smaller.
Making it bigger or smaller. So let's all do that. Let's start small. And a Susie, a Susie, a Susie Q. A Susie, a Susie, now make it big. And Susie, a Susie, a Susie, Q. A Susie, a Susie, a Susie, Q. So you can travel, you can make it big, or you can make it on the spot. Somebody else, tell me one more thing we can do with the Susie Q.
Bigger arms.
Bigger arms?
Bigger arms, different arms. So what could we do? We could go Susie. A Susie, a Susie Q, a Susie, a Susie, a Susie Q. We could do a Susie, a Susie, a Susie Q. We could take the arms, a Susie, a Susie, a Susie Q. I'm not trying to show you one particular move, just giving you flavours. You can pump the arms out, you can jazz hand it, you can move around in a circle. You might want to just make it more shoulders and less hands. So let's play with just thinking about the arms. So, can we have a burst of music?
Sure.
We've got big, we've got small, we've got arms. So it's just improvising the Susie Q.
Both Lynette and Elizabeth have stopped.
Can you make it louder?
Okay, yeah, I'll just make it louder. Yeah. Okay.
Sorry. Maybe turn it up on the computer?
Yeah, yes.
One more time. Did anyone do anything differently?
Do you come up with...
They're all on mute.
Yeah.
Just hands. Yeah, so I try to do something different every couple of bars. I was trying to change it up, because it's nice when you do this sort of practice to try and challenge yourself.
I saw a lot of things about big and small and the hands, which is a little bit more the polishing, but not so much the depth of the mood, like maybe some level changes or changes in rhythms. So maybe let's try and explore things that you don't normally do.
Okay, but let's first of all have another move. Has anyone else got another move for us?
Somebody else maybe?
Somebody else?
Kickball change.
Kickball change.
Great move. Combination.
So, we said explore level changes. Could be up, down, out to the side. It could be level changes. What else could we explore? Rhythms. Kickball change, kickball change.
Pardon? Turning it around in a circle. Around in a circle, very nice. Changing the shape. That's really nice. How about broken record? Kick and kick and kick and kick. Ball change, ball change, ball change, ball change. So you can break the move in two and play your broken record with one part of it. So we still have big and small, we still have different arms. We took it around, we went up and down, and we can change the rhythm, and we can change
and of course,
the record.
If you do it on one foot, should also be able to do it on the other foot.
Especially the foot that feels weird. If it feels weird, it probably needs practice.
Okay, so we're going to try again. We're focused at the beginning on kickball changes. Try it with the wrong foot. Try it with the other foot. Try it big, try it small, try a rhythm change, kick, or change, kick, or change. Play with the rhythms, play with the arms, big, small, high, low, level changes. Yeah, you got it. And then we're going to shorty,
maybe you can call
Susie Q at the end.
One idea at a time, maybe, as you do it.
Yeah, okay.
Just to experiment a bit slower. Okay, music.
So I'm starting on my not so usual foot.
Other foot.
One where I did a kick or change step, kick or change step, kick or change step. So I alternated the feet. Yeah. That was a simple one.
I think Elizabeth actually found the same by coincidentally.
Cool. We also did, I added in the Susie Q and I went kick or change, kick or change, kick Susie Q. Kick or change, kick or change, kick Susie Q. So you can begin to interweave the merge steps. Okay, have we got time for the last one, or do we need to start the routine?
Let's do the last one.
Last move. Elizabeth, demonstrate a move for us. Demonstrate one move.
Not sure if she can hear us.
I'm not sure she can hear us. Okay, have we got one more move that we want to play with? One more move.
Shoe shines.
Shoe shines.
Shoe shines. So, sometimes I do it with a brush, and sometimes I do it with a polish.
And you can
maybe up there. So, what can we do with shoe shines?
You can turn it around a bit like a pivot step, but with shoe shine.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah.
So we can make it very elegant.
And you can come up on your heel.
Come up on the heel?
I think we did that in one of our early online classes, actually. We did that. 1, 2.
Oh, yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's a way to. So instead of just keeping it on the floor, you could actually come on that. Come on that foot, whether you do a shine or not.
Oh, I'm sorry. Doing out my shoelace. It keeps coming undone tonight.
Is your shoe shine?
My shoelace. Doing up the shoelace. Okay. Should we try some shoe shines?
Sure.
Oh,
well,
Emma,
put some
you're
music on.
On
the second, maybe the next song. Is it a bit slower?
Oh, yeah. Shoe shines. Oh, Lynette's got the shine there. Oh, elegance. Ooh, yeah. It's like a shoe shine and a Suzy Q. Try and mix a shoe shine and the Suzy Q. Maybe slow it down. And the kick will change.
Nobody loves me. They don't even seem to care.
And relax. Cool. So we're hoping that what you can do is start to also combine, but you might not think a Suzy Q and a shoe shine. They're two separate moves, and yes, they are separate moves in their own right, but then you can make something out of them. You can do a Suzy Q with a shoe shine. Yeah, so, and it's just an example of being creative and trying to learn how to improvise. Just start simple. Start with one move and improvise. Big, small, up, down, arms, level changes, rhythms, slows, freezes. Then combine it with two moves and then try and combine it with 3, 4, 5, 6 and 100 moves.
The advantage with those exercises is that you will come up with things, you'll get your body to make movements that you wouldn't come up with if you just play a song and just start improvising. And sometimes you watch others and say, I don't know how they are so creative or how they could react to the music, but it's because they've put the hours of practice to explore different directions and different types of movements with their body before they can come up with that.
Yeah, brilliant. The other thing I'd like to say is try to make whatever you do crisp. Make it clean. That doesn't mean you can't mix things, but sometimes it gets a little bit blurry, like, was it a Suzy Q, or was it a kick will change, or was it a shoe shine? You tend to sort of, you know, you can't quite tell the difference, because in your head you're thinking of all of them. So each one, each section, even if you start with a Suzy Q, if you do two steps of a Suzy Q, freeze. That was your Suzy Q, now go into a shoe shine. It's got to be very clearly distinct, a difference between the moves.
And it has to be deliberate. It has to, or, well, the aim is that it is deliberate and that each movement is full.
One last time, you've got three moves to improvise around. Ready? And do your own thing and just have fun and use the music. Let the music start to tell you what to do. Yeah, try and hear the breaks and the phrases. Shoe shine is Now don't repeat the same move. If you did it one way, do it differently the next time. Nice, and a turn, that was good. Yeah, hear the blues. Oh yeah. Move it, baby, move it. Oh yeah. In that blues. Ooh, yeah. All right, change it up, change it up. Something different now. Yeah, nice work, nice work. And it is, that's fun. And you know something? That's so easy for you guys to stick on some music and just find different ways to interpret music, and that's how you get better.
How about they're looking for music?
If you're looking for music, yeah, we have some music on our website, but that's more Lindy Hop. But I will put some more jazzy stuff on there as well.
Okay.
But just find music you like. But yeah, I'll get some of my favourite and your favourite jazz songs to put up on the site. That'd be a good idea. Right, should we get started with the routine?
Yes.
Now you're warmed up.
Just about. Okay, we're going to start with a Shorty George, but not any Shorty George. It's going to go up and down. We talked about changing levels, so we're going to go up and down and up and down. A down and up, a down and up. A five, six, five, six, seven, eight, a Shorty. Down and up we go. From here, we've gone forward, let's go back. We're gonna go clap and some bottoms back. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. Little shuffles. And just for studying, we're gonna choose to clasp the hand in front.
Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. It's almost like a duck waddle.
Yeah, almost. So the feet are a little bit apart, yeah.
Yeah.
I see what you mean. So we've got that sort of flowy Shorty George and that more rigid going backwards. Together, five, six, and eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, and eight, and one, two, three. Let's repeat, eight, and one, two, three, five, six, and we go back, two, three, and five, six, seven.
Okay, just one teeny weeny thing.
Yeah.
When you clasp the hands together to go back, I wouldn't have them too high. I'd have them down, and maybe that will help your shoulders relax, because I think the shoulders were coming up as you were clasping the hands, and it looks, yeah, so the hands are quite relaxed. And where is the waddle? Where is it, like, where's it all coming from?
It's probably pushing off from the floor, actually. I'm sort of pushing off from one foot onto the other. It's almost like a roll. Boom, boom, boom. I'm pushing off the left foot to the right, and it rolls back onto the left, and roll. And roll, and roll.
And also, if you do it from the side, imagine you've got a handle on your back, and somebody just above the hip, and somebody's pulling you from that handle, and they're pulling you back, and you're shuffling back. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum.
Yeah, so it's my backside who's crossing the line first.
Yeah. Okay, let's try that again. So Shorty George.
Five, a six, a five, six. Seven and shorty, 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 George. A back, two, three, four, five, six, seven. A one,
repeat.
Two, three, five, six, seven. A one, two, three, a five, six, seven, eight. Finishing on the left foot. Should we continue?
Yep. I just want to say, when you do the Shorty George, there's one thing I noticed. Just do it one more time. I forgot what I was going to say. Do it one more time, Shorty George. Oh yeah, you're pushing through the feet to get some of the height. It's not just the knees.
The knees are pretty constant. So if I did it without the crazy knees, it's just coming on the toes and going down into the floor.
Yeah, so really pushing off the toes. Okay, let's carry on.
Right, we finished on our left foot. We're going to go into boogie drops on the right. A boogie drop is a slow, and then we're going to have a rock, rock, quick, quick. Rock, rock. There he goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to emphasize it and also help myself by moving the torso first. Ha, ha, ha. Back, forward. Now I'm always thinking elbow, elbow, just to visualize it. It's the whole body, of course, but it's quite sharp, sharp. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3. Ha, ha. Because we've got that ha, ha, we can use that extra energy. We're actually going to make it a turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After the ha, ha, the turn's actually quite slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I step down on 8. So you go 5, 6, 7, slow, sort of hovering, and down 8.
Could you do that once maybe without the turn, so people can see just that hovering feeling in without the turn? Maybe take one step forward. Yeah, thank you.
From the boogie drop, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, let's all do that once.
So there's that little lift and drop, but not lift completely, straight legs. 5, 6, 7, and boogie drop. Quick, ha, down. One more time, I'll just count it out. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Drop. Good,
so
okay.
So practice, let's do it on the other leg,
yep.
Because we're going to need it. At 5, 6, 7, and the boogie drop, quick up, down. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And if you're like me, you've probably got one leg that's better than the other.
Yeah, or one leg that feels more comfortable.
Yeah. So one more time.
One more time on the left.
Foot.
At 5, 6, 7, and a boogie drop, quick up, down.
Okay, so now let's see
add the turn. So take your time in the turn. It's not a big turn, and you've got 2 or almost 3 beats to get.
Left or right?
Let's do the right first. 5, 6, 7, and boogie drop, rock
turn.
Up, down.
Nice.
Keeping it. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Good. Should we try the other leg?
Yeah. Let's do it to the left. Our favourite leg. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And so down on the right foot.
Nice. All the people seem to do better on that side. One more time.
5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah. Lovely.
Yeah. It's your best side. And so we're going to do those two sides, but we're going to have some. Forgot the name of the move, I know the move. Simon, help me out.
Fishtails.
Fishtails, thank you. Just got out of my mind. So we're gonna go. A boogie drop, rock, boom, down, fish, tail. A quick, slow, finishing on the right foot, going to the left. Boogie drop, back, turn, down, fish, down to the left. A quick, slow.
Okay,
they're very silent, but maybe that's just because they're all on mute.
Oh, yes. So,
boogie,
do you want to
right.
Break down which way they start? Do you want to go forward one step?
Yeah, we'll do it. Really?
Well, because you travel back on the fishtails.
Yeah, okay. Let's do the boogie to the right and freeze. Well, the 8 count of the boogie. 5, 6, 7, and boogie, drop, rock, turn, down. I've just put the left foot down, so I'm going to push up the left onto the right foot.
Slow.
So I really go into the floor slow, and then we go slow to the left,
and then,
quick, slow.
Yeah, everyone seems okay with the fishtails, so that's good.
Okay, from here we finish on our right foot, we're ready to go on the left for the boogie. 5, 6, 7, and boogie, drop, rock, turn, down. This time I'm pushing off the right foot onto the left, the right, a quick, slow.
Cool, let's put that all
so
together.
So we do that sequence of 4, boogies, fishtail, boogie, fishtail.
Here we go.
5, 6, 7, and a boogie, drop, quick, slow, down, fish, tail, a quick, slow. We go boogie, drop, and turn, down, back, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Cool, add it together with the shorter George,
yes,
once without music, then once with music.
Yep.
Shorty George and the Shuffle, twice through.
A five, a six, a five, six, seven. A one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. A one, two, three, five, six, seven. A three, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Shuffle.
A four, two, three. A
boogie drop.
Boogie drop. We go boogie drop. Quick turn down. Fish tail. A quick, quick slow. A boogie drop. And turn down. Back, two, three. A five, six, seven. Can we finish the last?
Yeah, boogie forward. And this. And
we go two boogie forwards. Eight. One, two, three. Then we're going to use a similar shape to the boogie forward, but we're going to leave the right foot on the floor and sweep. Five, six, seven, and put the foot down on eight. So it's a boogie, a sweep, and a sweep down. As an optional extra, you can add a little traveling with the left foot. So if I take out the right foot for a minute, I got a boogie, a heel, toe, heel. Let's do that. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and a heel, toe, heel.
Why don't we just practice that boogie just once going across the room?
The heel toe?
Yeah, heel toe.
Okay, we can do that. No problem. Stand on the left of your room or your space. And we start with the weight on the ball of the left foot. And we go heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. Heel, toe, heel, toe. I don't know how big your room is.
And why don't you styling with the other leg? Oh, let's get back on the other foot.
Wait, let's come back first. Same thing, this time we stand on the right foot. And we go heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. Try and make it controlled. Okay. Now, was that okay?
Yeah.
Now, at the same time as our heel toe, we're going to add our sweep on the right
foot. Little circles.
Little circle. So just do it on the spot, like
clockwise.
Yeah, clockwise. Yes, you can do it the other way. And let's add our traveling set. So we go heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel.
Nice.
See that I'm leaning away.
People running out of room.
I'm leaning away from the direction I'm going into to counterbalance for my legs, so I can keep my balance. This is my center, everything in line. If I send something out, it's slightly easier to counterbalance with the top of the body. And soft knees, so I can do that for hours.
Let's try the other way.
Let's come back. We don't need it for this routine, but we might as well practice. So heel toe on the right. Let's try a little sweep on the left. And when you're ready, add the heel toe. And this time I'm going to lean to the right.
Nice. So,
okay, we only need to do it twice. So with the boogie forwards first, it goes boogie forward, and a broad sweep.
From the fishtail?
Let's do that one more time, just the boogie forward, five, six, and boogie forward, and a broad sweep. From everything?
Yeah, with music?
With music.
Let's go for it. It's slow music, so yeah. It's okay.
Today we've got slow, so really take your time and really go deep into each move. Do it fully.
So it's Sugar Blues by Clyde McCoy.
The real McCoy.
Shuffle. Fish tail. Boogie drops. Boogie forward. Nice. All right. I think everyone's good.
Excellent.
Do you want to move on?
Sure. So from here, we've just done...
Is that his favourite step?
It is. The Josephine Baker. We've done two sweeps on the right. Five, six, seven. And I'm going to put the foot down on eight. So I'm ready. My left foot is free. And now we're going to imagine you're going to bring your left foot as far as it goes. Now you're going to pick it up, bend the knee, and bring it back in, like a reverse bicycle motion. The further out you go, the bigger circle you can make. So bring it in, out, up, in, out, up,
in. Could you do it once from the side?
So one, two, bend into your right hip. So again, because you're sending your left leg out, you want to counterbalance that movement. So the further out I go, the further down and out with my hip I go. Ha. Ha. From the side?
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah, so we can see it's not about your knee coming forward. It does come forward, but it's not pushing forward. It's pushing to the side.
Side, up, down. Side, up, down. Let's try the other foot because we're going to get tight on that leg. So bend a little bit the left foot. Send your right foot out as far as it goes, but still on the floor. And lift it up, bend the knee. Bring the knee in and down. Out, up, down. Out, up, down. Out, up, down. And find that balance with the left hip. Sometimes you'll find that you're not quite far enough, so you're going to fall to the right. So correct by sending the hip further out. Ha.
Could you, just to emphasise one difference of what we're going to try and do when we're dancing, Hannah faces us, could you do it by just being as still as possible with the rest of the body and just lifting the leg up in the motion?
Okay, if I do, that would be quite balletic, so I could do this.
And do it just like, just lift it up, So it's not technically wrong, but it's missing, not what we're doing.
It's missing the hips, actually. So I really want to use the hips in this style for jazz. I really want to get down and I really want to get that groovy motion. So although I was talking about the hips for counterbalancing, when I bring my foot out and up, it's actually going to come from the hips and we're going to start to accentuate that. So it's not just the foot moving, but the hip moving. So let's try again. Stand on the right foot and this time visualize your left hip, this one. And make it do a little circle. Down and up. Down and up. Down
better.
And up.
Better. Down. Think and of the hip.
Let's change foot. Stand on the left. Draw a circle with your right hip. Down, up, in. Down, up, in. Little circle.
Yeah, I think the hip makes it look very different to just lifting the leg up. That's really
now
nice.
Now let's alternate then. So I'm going to go one on the left and step on that left foot, one on the right and step in. Left step, right step. Which means you have to alternate the hips as well, which is the tricky part. So left hip goes down, right hip goes down. One, two. One, two. And to make it look really nice, you want to sort of isolate that hips and bottom. Of course, there's going to be a little movement in the top. But for now, we don't want it too crazy at the same time. We're going to put the emphasis on the hips and the crazy legs.
It's quite a sexy move, really.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Josephine Baker, should we just try that, just with music?
Sure.
Just that movement. Maybe start facing us for a little bit and then turn around.
Yeah, actually, it's the same. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7.
So it has, I call it, it's got a little bit of a snaky feel to it.
Yeah.
It's snaky.
It's very much, it's quite sensual and eccentric at the same time, which is very Josephine Baker. She was one of the few dancers or performers who managed to be very sexy, very womanly. She was a sex symbol and she was funny at the same time with the same number. And so that one of her steps that shows the both things, quite a funny look, but at the same time, you're really showing a lot of curves and curvy movements.
Cool.
Let's add rhythm. We're going to go, I'm going to turn around. We just stepped on the right foot. So we're going to go a slow, a quick, quick slow. Slow, slow, a quick, quick slow. So we can feel as well that here in the quick, quick, we can just keep it small and play with the hips mostly. 5, 6, 7 and slow, slow, a quick, quick slow. Slow, slow, a quick, quick, slow. Ha, a ha, a dee, da, da. A ha, a ha, a di da da. We're going to do two of these, and then we're going to...
Is that recording?
Yes.
Yeah, good. Okay, yeah, you can't see. Okay.
We're going to do two of these. It's in the mirror, Simon. Two of these, and then we're going to go around. So, starting on the right foot, let's go. Slow, slow, a quick, quick, slow, 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 a quick, quick, slow. Forward, let's not turn it, but it's going to go forward, forward, close, forward, or left, right, close, right. And if I do it this way, you're going to see that, again, there's very much away from the hips, body roll. So I go away from my foot when I step in, and then you roll forward and back. Ha, di, ha, aha, di, ha. Think, you know, exotic.
So whereas just the hips were going sideways, now they're going forward and back.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we had side, nice. This side, and now that side. Let's just take those two steps and turn them around. So if you watch it once to see what I mean. One, two, three, five, six, seven. So it's quite quick to get around. We have those two step to get around. Five, six, seven, we go left. Close, left, right, close, right.
Let's and then we're going to
change weight very quickly on the eight, actually. Five, six, seven.
Round one, in two, a circle.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
I think when you go round, are you leading with the hip?
Well, the hip is going away, actually.
So you're turning your body.
I'm how do you leading turn from around? The. You mean to turn or to
yeah.
move?
I think your chest is turning. Yeah,
yeah, it's the top of
the chest
body.
Is leading.
So
okay,
if I'm
forward.
Facing you, this is initiating the move. It's really from the chest, the rib cage.
Yeah. So turn the chest to get the travel.
Let's do our Josephine Baker, our two turning moves, and stepping on eight at the end. A five, six, seven, eight. One, two, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We
around.
Go around, we go around, we go step.
Music?
Music from the top?
No, just that move. I think.
Just that, okay?
Yeah. Josephine Baker. Five, six, seven. I notice is you're not leading the Josephine Baker from the knee, you're
no,
leading it from the
from
leg,
the hip,
yeah, from the hip.
Yeah, it's the so let's do an exercise then. Stand on either foot and just shake your free leg and just make sure it's completely relaxed. Now we're going to try and isolate, find that control in the hip. So without tensing the leg, try and lift to one side and relax. Lift the hip to one side and relax. So you're trying, imagine you've got a button just above and you're trying to hit it with your hip. And see how that lifts the leg. Now, give it a little bit more impulse and see how it's the hip that's starting the movement and it's leading your leg. All we're doing is we continue the movement with the leg. So this is led from the leg and adding the hip. This is led from the hip and adding the leg, and we want the second one. We start the movement from the hip, we add the leg to finish. Hip, leg, hip, leg. Same on the other foot. Whew, relax. Shake that other leg off, especially because you've been standing on it. Completely relax. Try to hit that button just with the hip and button. And now lift with the leg and then add the foot, or the leg rather, sorry. Lift with the hip and add the leg. Lift with the hip, add the leg and close. Lift with the hip, add the leg and close. So as long as you need to break it down, just do it breaking it down, and then at some point it will flow. So you do one after the other. But what we don't want is the leg and then the hip, or just the leg.
Or the knee. Good. From the top.
From the top, from the short jaws.
Are you ready? A one. I'm ready. A two. You know what to do, Shorty George.
The straightening music. And one, two, three, five, six, seven. Going back. Shorty George. Going back. Boogie drops. One, two, three, five, six, seven, and back. Three, five,
question. Is the heel on the supporting leg coming off the floor in the Josephine Baker? Is the heel, on the supporting, when you do Josephine Baker, are you lifting up on the toes you did in the Shorty George? Very slightly.
A little bit. Actually, I'm going more on the outside of the foot than the front of the foot. I'm not sure. I wasn't thinking about it. I think what I do is going on the outside of my foot mainly. There's a little lift, but it's more from the hip. I'm not trying to push off from the feet. It's just because my hip is going up that there's a little lift happening.
So it comes off the floor, but you're not thinking about it. It just it follows the flow of the move.
I wouldn't recommend to push off.
Does that answer your question? Thumbs up, yeah, cool.
Good.
Let's add the last step and then we'll repeat that. Because there's last step of this section, and then we'll see if we've got time for the last section.
Okay, so we finish with a forward, go forward, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Flash break. We're standing on the left foot. We're going to swing our right foot. And it's a bit like a brush. It's not like a Charleston kick, it's more a brush forward and a brush back. Let's do that a few times. Brush forward and back, and forward and back, and forward.
And I notice your supporting leg goes in the same direction.
Yeah. One, two, yeah. So there's a little shuffle going, like a little chug going on my left foot. Chug forward, chug back, as a result of swinging the legs. Swing forward and back, and forward and back.
And can I just interrupt and say one thing? You do have to be careful if you try this on a slippery floor and you've got slippery shoes. I've seen people go flat on their face. So
please don't.
So make sure that you do it in control. Yes. Sometimes if you're going to perform it, you want to take it to the limit of that kick. And you do have to be careful because I've seen people fall over.
Yes, so be a little bit careful. And be aware of your environment. You can do it small. For now, we're going to add a rhythm. We're going to go slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick. Five, six, seven, and slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick. Let's just do one of them, slow, slow, quick, quick, and freeze. Five, six, seven, and slow,
forward, slow, back,
quick,
forward,
quick.
Back.
From here, I'm going to take the right leg forward and the left leg back. So what's going to happen simultaneously is my right leg is going to come in front and stomp, and my left leg is going to slide back, that little chug that we were doing. So at the same time, right leg comes forward, left leg chugs back, we go, ha! The weight ends up on the front. So as I bring my foot, that right foot in front, I'm putting my weight on it. So it's that fun effect, the John Bobbles style move.
And you don't even need to have any weight on the back foot, it could all be on the front foot.
Yeah, it is 100% on the front foot. So let's do kick slow, slow, kick, kick, and switch. Five, six, seven, and slow, slow, quick, quick, switch.
So So the heel follows the leg in all the moves except for the last one where it goes in reverse.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and we've got a question.
Yeah.
Do you have the feet turn out on that step?
No, it's pretty parallel. So
yeah, feet are parallel.
One, two, three. It's very skiing-like.
Parallel feet.
Skiing feet. Let's do the last one more time. So standing on the left, all the weight is forward on the left, the right foot is behind. Think, sliding the left foot and standing, stepping forward with the right foot. At the same time, we go now.
Okay, can I just say one thing? It's important. You're basically jumping. And anytime you jump, when you land, you want to cushion the landing with a little bend. Don't try and jump on a straight leg.
Yeah, important point. One more time. Soft knees. Don't put too much energy. It's just about getting that type of movement in your body. So bend left leg and switch. One more time. Is that okay? How is it looking?
Quick. Shoom. Yeah, looking good. Everyone's looking really good.
Excellent. That's a really tricky one. Okay. So, quick switch. 5, 6, 5, 6, and we go. So, quick switch. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and so, quick switch. Can we do it from the Josephine Baker? So we got a real contrast here of some slow and sensual, and some really strong and straight moves and some leg flicks. 5, 6, standing on the right, and 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 2, 2, 5, 6, 7, going round, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, down, kick, so a quick switch.
Nice, with music.
From the top, with music,
just that bit.
Where from? Just Josephine?
Yeah, Josephine Baker.
Josephine Baker. So standing on the right foot.
From the top.
Oh, too late.
Okay, one more time.
And 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Ups and downs.
Shuffle.
1, 2, 3.
Boogie drop.
1, 2, 3.
Around.
5, 6, 7.
Fish down. Forward and sweep. Josephine Baker. Traveling in a circle.
Hips forward and back. 5, 6,
bubbles break.
1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Nice. One more time.
From the top. It starts. What?
Sorry.
Yeah, just 1 second. Ruid starts right away.
Here we go, one more time. Okay, it's just coming on. And music.
Keep drop.
it one more time, but it's not about doing the steps, it's about dancing it. So any tips about how to dance the steps as opposed to do the steps?
So you probably thought, oh, finally a slow song, that's good. And then when we tried to do it, it's like, oh my gosh, it's really slow, it's hard. Slower is actually harder than really fast, I think, because you have to be a lot more in control of your movement and actually really feel the space when you dance. So you can't just camouflage by keep moving. You have to really accentuate everything. So in our ups and downs, again, you can't just mark things. You have to go really down, really up. Try and make every step count. So really deliberate. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Same thing with the Josephine Baker. You have to take your time through it, which means you need the balance as well. So try and feel the balance happening, really the counterbalance when you go around. And that will actually give character to your moves as well. And you might find that by lifting the arm, you can find your balance better, but it also looks quite nice. So try and fill more space.
Okay, so either you can take the character of Josephine Baker throughout this dance. Imagine you've got the feathers, the banana skirt, and think, how would you dance this? Or maybe you want to think John Bubbles, and you're in your tails and sophisticated, and you have a little sort of the poise and elegance of John Bubbles. So pick your style and let's do it one more time. And Joanna said, listen to the beat and the instruments. Absolutely. This song is, you can really hear what these guys, they're playing with their soul, and that's what we're looking for. Okay, go straight into it. Here we go.
With those ideas in mind, did it feel different for you?
Yeah, if you want to unmute yourself, if you've got any comments.
That does.
It was a lot better than the second time.
Yeah,
I think because you were thinking more about dancing it rather than just stepping it.
Any thoughts about dancing to slower music?
The beat and the tempo is a lot more, it's taking its time a lot.
Yep, absolutely, definitely. You've definitely got more time to fill things out, to express it.
Anyone else, do you find it harder, easier?
Because I go for Lindy and Balboa, I've got a bit of a tendency to chase the beat a bit.
Yes.
I think when it slows down, I tend to sort of want to come in faster.
Ah, brilliant. This is a routine to be a little bit behind the beat. This is perfect for that. This is like you want to lay back. And it's almost like you're floating through some of these moves. Especially when you do the turn. It's like you float through the turn, but with that jazz flavour as opposed to a ballet flavour. Yeah.
You imagine it's like, I'm not in a hurry. They'll wait for me.
Cool. Okay. Should we try it one more time?
With all those in mind. Excellent.
Here we go. One more time. Music coming on. Let me see the sensuality of the moves. Boop. that looks so much nicer, guys. Well done.
Ladies, really, tonight.
Oh, ladies, yes. It looks a lot better. Yeah, it's very different dancing to that slow music. You can really hear the music. Yeah.
Great. Hope you enjoyed tonight. We'll be back next week. Hope you have a great week ahead. A lot of sunshine, apparently, so take advantage of the third heat wave of the year.
And then next week is normal. And then when we go into October, we've moved it back by half an hour because we've had a few requests to do it just half an hour later. So it's a lot of people coming in from work and they're rushing to get here. So we actually get, you know, there's more people who have signed in, but they I think they're watching the replays, which are quite good.
They're working.
Talking of which, we hope to have our website, our membership site up soon, when all the replays will be on there and you can catch all the lessons, because this is number 17, isn't it?
Oh, right.
So there'd be like
ahead of me.
There'd be like all the classes, the ABC classes, these classes will all be on the website. It's not quite up yet. We've just got the first tier with all the swing notes and a few sample classes, but it should be quite good once it's all ready. Big job.